Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to use Microsoft Designer, which is an AI image editor. So let's get started. So first thing, just Google Microsoft Designer and you'll be getting the designer.microsoft.com link, and make sure that you are signing in with your Microsoft account. And this is the interface that you will be getting. With the help of this, you can create AI images as well as icons, wallpapers, invitations, banners. It has so many of these options, and apart from this, you can also edit with AI. So I will just click here, and these are the features that it gives us. First one is editing the image, removing background, frame images, and generative arrays. So let's see one by one. First, let me go with edit image. So I'll just select this, and here it asks me to upload an image. Let me just upload one. So this is the image that I have uploaded. So basically there is a car and this is Earth and which have another moon. So this is basically the image. And we have multiple options over here. For example, first one, we are having the normal filters. This is standard. And apart from that, we are having the remove background, blur, color, erase, move, cutout. And the thing is, this tool is not entirely free. Some of these features will cost you credits. So I guess by default, you will be having 15 credits. Will get automatically refreshed, and if you want, you can buy some credits also. So first, let's just go with a feature. For example, here they are having the move feature. So I will just click here, the move. Basically, we can select an object. So as you can see here, imagine I want to move this particular car somewhere else, or I want to move the moon to somewhere else. What I can do is, here you are having two options. One is brush select and the normal select. If I select brush, I need to draw this way and select it. So if you just hover over the particular image, with the help of AI, it will itself automatically detect each and every object. So that's so amazing. I will just go with the normal select and click on this moon. Once I click this, I will just click on move. And as you can see, this uses one AI credit. So now we had 14, right? It will be 13. And not all features cost credit, but if it's going to cost you, it will automatically appear there. And now this moon is draggable. So now I can just literally drag it anywhere else. I want to put it here. That's it. So this is basically how you can use this feature. And if you want to delete it, you can literally delete this also. Boom, that's gone. And the background automatically filled without you worrying. So that's an amazing feature from Move. And next one, let's try with the erase feature. So I'll just click on erase. This also has two options. One with the brush. Another one is with the select. So I'll just go with the brush this time, and I will just go with this car. Let me just remove this car itself and see how it behaves. So I will just draw this along with the shadow also. I will just click on erase. This also uses one credit, and boom, just look at this. There is no trace of that car. So such a handy tool in case if you want to do selective erase functionalities. And if you want to undo, you're having the undo option at the top, which basically brings back the car as well as the moon. It's in the normal image right now. And apart from that, we are having the background, which is remove background, blur and color. So if I click on remove, so this will basically now remove the background. And I guess this feature isn't costing us any credits. And we are having the blur background. So this feature also, blur, doesn't cost us any credit. And the amazing thing is, with just a click of a button, it blurs only the background. So as you saw that, right, this is the old image. We are having everything focused, even the Earth and the moon is focused. But after that blur, it literally focuses the car alone. And we are able to do this within a snap, just even a button click, and absolutely for free. So this is also another cool feature that you can use. And next one, they're having the color background, which basically, I guess, removes the entire background and allows us to choose a color, something like this. And I'm not sure how many people will use this, but this is also a free feature available. And create sticker. So I'll just select this and create sticker. And that's it. This becomes a sticker, a copy of this car becomes a sticker. You can just download it and use it in your chats, something like that. Create sticker option. And this also doesn't cost any credits. So basically only the erase and the move functionality costs us credits. And apart from this, we are also having the focus and color pop. So if you click on focus, we need to select that object and click on focus. Yeah, this is also quite similar to the blur background, exactly that. And finally, we are having the color pop and crop. So this basically allows only that particular image that you're selecting to be colored and makes it look unique in the entire image, and rest of the things are going into gray color. So that's basically color pop. So these are the features that are available in image editing. If you want, you can just try this out. And apart from these features, if you go to like this visuals, you are having so many of the shapes and graphic things available. You can just try around with that also. And we are having the frame images in case if you want to create a frame over your image, something like this. So you can also try this out. You need to just add a particular image. So I'll just add one. So I have selected the image, and next let me add the elements. So this basically corresponds to the elements in the frame. For example, here you can see they're having flowers. Here they're having this makeup kit. So here they're having balloons. So you need to just have those things onto your frame. So I will just go with trees and plants, something like this. And style, we are having so many options to choose from, like illustration, watercolor, pencil sketch. I will go with steampunk and click on generate. So this will also use one credit. And just look at this. This looks so stunning. Like, this is the image that I gave, and I'm having the frames of the theme trees and plants. That looks super good. And if you want to download it, you can download, or if you want to edit it again, like, this will take us to the exact same interface that we used. We are having the same options that we used to edit it. And apart from this, they are having so much other stuff too, creating invitations, banners, posters. You can just go here and describe what you want to create, add images, and select a poster size, and this will, you know, give you some quick edit posters like this. You can just try it out as well. And it can also generate images. So I go here, images, and here we need to give the description what we want to generate, and here we are having the size of the image. So I'll just go with a warrior from 15th century, and this is the size that I've given, and this also cost around one credit. And these are the images that I am getting. And let's say you want to edit one of these images, you can just directly click on this edit, and this will take you to the exact same editing interface. So not only you can generate AI images, but you can literally also edit them in a flash. And like, let's blur the background. It has literally blurred the entire background, keeping our main subject idle. So this is basically it, guys. Such a good tool. And if you want to just use it, you can just try it out. Quickly creates icons, wallpapers and stuff, edit images. And apart from that, you can also design so much of stuff like this for your story photo. It has also got these features available too. So like templates, illustrations. So you can also like use this in case if you want to, like, you know, have a quick work, you're having the search, you can just try this out also. So has a lot of features. Try it and let me know. And I hope you'd have found it useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.